Hey, welcome to Funnel's YouTube channel, where I talk all things digital marketing, data visualization, and marketing analytics. All of the great content you need to shortcut your way to being a better marketer. In this video, I'm going to explain how Performance Max campaigns work, give you some Performance Max campaigns best practices, and give you a heads up for some of the things you need to be aware of when it comes to Performance Max campaigns and how you run them. So stick around for those. What are Performance Max campaigns in Google Ads? Performance Max campaigns are Google's newest campaign type and involve even more automation and machine learning than previous campaign types. This means less optimization powered by bid adjustments and campaign settings, and more optimization by feeding Google data and information. So if you don't have your data handy, better get to it. But more on that later. How do Performance Max campaigns work? So, how do Performance Max campaigns work? Previously, most Google campaigns have worked individually with each Google product. That means a Google Ads search campaign served ads on the Google SERP. Dynamic display ads served ads on the Google Display Network, while smart shopping campaigns served ads on the Google Shopping SERP. Performance Max campaigns brings all those Google products into one, allowing ads to be served across the whole of Google. Yes, literally like all of Google, including Google SERP, Google Shopping SERP, YouTube, Google's Display Network, Google Maps, and Gmail ads. Think of it like a huge, super powerful RSA combined with the discovery ad that you feed creatives, ad copy, and information, and it combines it all together to achieve what digital advertising has always been trying to achieve. To serve the right ad to the right person at the right time. But now it's also adding in the right format. How are Performance Max campaigns different than other campaigns? Even though Google has made most campaigns relatively automated, Performance Max takes things to a whole new level. With previous campaigns, you had campaigns, ad groups, and ads. With Performance Max campaigns, you only have campaigns and asset groups. But you can't actually see the asset group as a breakdown, so for all intents and purposes, it's essentially just campaign level. More on that later when I talk through how to set things up and also how to analyze them. Are they only for e-commerce businesses? I just wanted to address a common question I've been getting about this campaign type. A lot of marketers have been asking me if Performance Max campaigns are simply just for e-commerce businesses. This has become a common question because they do bring shopping into the mix. But the short answer is no. Let me explain. Previously, discovery campaigns served ads across all of the Google network besides shopping and search, while smart shopping campaigns were solely focused on shopping and search on search. Now shopping and search have both been combined into Performance Max, meaning that even if you don't have a shopping feed, you can still benefit from search being a possible placement for the algorithm. So no, they aren't only for e-commerce businesses, but I would hedge to say that e-com businesses will see the best results because they will benefit most from shopping being a possible placement. Are they worth testing? So should you test Performance Max campaigns? In short, yes. Google has continually improved the big bad algorithm at the heart of the machine, and in turn proved us marketers wrong about whether or not the robot actually knows better than us. My advice is to give it as much information as you can and give it a whirl. But given the limited visibility, testing options are also more limited. So definitely don't just switch over to Performance Max. Keep other campaign types running and feed your learnings into your Performance Max campaign because it can only do its best with what you feed into it. Remember, crap creatives will always be crap regardless of how they're placed on someone's screen. How to set up Performance Max campaigns and best practices to follow. Okay, so you know what Performance Max campaigns are, you're taking my advice and want to give them a whirl. Here's how we tested them internally and saw some interesting results. Number one, trust the process. For starters, I mentioned how Performance Max campaigns offer less flexibility. This is the classic trade-off Google has offered each time it's introduced new types of campaigns that favor less human intervention and more trust for the algorithm. That does, however, mean the setup is fairly straightforward, which is good. Number two, I recommend that you start with one asset group per campaign. Given that there's no visibility at the asset group level, it's going to make it very difficult to get a good view on the difference in performance between asset groups. Number three, don't create too many campaigns. To mitigate the lack of visibility, go with one asset group per campaign, but remember not to segment too much and really consider if you actually need a separate campaign because the algorithm will benefit from grouping. Number four, add in your first party data. We're all familiar with lookalikes. And listen, Google's long been trying to find people similar to people who have bought your product or service or visited your website. And with Performance Max campaigns, Google wants you to feed it your first party data so it can use it as yet another signal to optimize with. Depending on how you've broken down your campaigns and what the goals of it are will determine which first party data you decide to add. But I'll be honest, if you do this well and have a good first party data structure, this could be a winner for you. For example, if you segment campaigns based on product offering, let's say men's clothes and women's clothes, you would want to feed different data. For the women's campaign, you would want to give it a Google Analytics audience of visitors to popular women's category pages, or a CRM audience of women's category converters, and vice versa for the men. Interpreting the performance of Performance Max campaigns. Okay. So you've decided to give Performance Max campaigns a whirl. Now you need to know how to interpret their performance. Performance, performance, performance. My Lord, how many times am I gonna say performance in this? Can we do like a command F of the footage afterwards or something? Okay, first things first. Remember that you can't look at the asset level performance. So your only breakdown is campaign level. I mentioned it earlier so you could structure your campaigns accordingly, but now it's just as important. Secondly, I recommend you look at your overall account performance from before and after, because Performance Max is so broad that it will inevitably almost overlap with your other campaign types. What I mean here is that one reason Performance Max could be looking good is because it's essentially stealing conversion from your other campaigns. Another thing to note is that we also notice a lot of brand and competitor keywords in our Performance Max campaigns, even though we had what we thought were good enough exclusion lists. So we learned to be super strict with exclusion lists for Performance Max. Last point on interpreting performance, and I think this is the most important one. You need to verify the quality of the conversions coming from Performance Max. Volume might look good on the surface, but not if that volume doesn't actually translate into revenue. Performance Max campaigns are so broad, which means they might pick up a lot of spam traffic in the beginning until you learn how to use them for your business. So don't be discouraged. Performance Max campaigns might work well for you, but be thorough in your testing and always think critically. That's it for Performance Max campaigns. If you found this video useful, subscribe where you'll get more videos about digital marketing best practices, marketing data and analytics, and data visualization tips and tricks. All the great content you need to shortcut your way to being a better marketer.